Testing 1, 2, check. Testing 1, 2, check. Test. Thank you. Good morning. If we could have everyone to find a seat, and then we'll start our service today. I'm sure glad that you're here. And it's always good to do a service where you absolutely know and are assured of someone's faith in Jesus Christ. And the last time that I saw Carl, he was ready to go. He said, what's your favorite verse? Carl, he said, John 3:16. We'll talk about that a little bit later in the service, but right now I want you to listen to one of his favorite songs by Zach Williams, Chainbreaker.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life. There's a better life. You got pain.
Father, we want to thank you for Carl Anderson's life. He marked every one of us in this room in a very special way, and he was a grandfather, I believe, to all, a dad to all. Kids seem to gravitate to him, and that shows me that he has the spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ living within him. And Father, we will miss Carl, but we know that soon we will be in the presence of Jesus Christ, those that have a personal relationship with the Lord. And we look forward to that time. That is a Christian's hope. But Father, right now there's a hurting family. We ask that you'd be with Lynn and her children, the family that's assembled here, all the friends that are grieving. We ask that you'd put your arms around us and love on us, Lord. For you are a good, good Father. And you love us so very much. I ask that we would experience that love today. I ask that the Word of God would be our source of strength and guide us to Jesus Christ if we do not know Him, at present. We ask that you would allow everything that's done and said here today to glorify and honor Carl's Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. We would also honor the memory of Carl as we minister to the family. We ask all these things in the precious and the powerful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and all of God's children said, amen. Okay, at this time, we're going to have a song by Brad Paisley.
Thank you. Good morning. Probably should have ended with that song instead of started with it, but you guys got to quit shedding tears because I don't know if I can hold it together through this. So, Lynn asked me if I would read the obituary and the eulogy for Carl. My name is Tony Gellerman. I'm a friend of Carl's, proud to say that a good friend of Carl's. Carl passed away peacefully on May 29, 2022, at the age of 74. He will be remembered for his unwavering love of the Lord as well as his affinity for the church family. Carl was born on April 9, 1948, in Scottsbluff, Nebraska, to Carl William Anderson and Marie Magdalene Anderson. Carl graduated high school in 1966 and proudly and bravely joined the United States Army 2 days later. While in the Army, he earned the rank of SP4, E4 Artillery, before being honorably discharged. After being discharged from the military, Carl pursued other jobs, but finished out his career as a truck driver for El Paso County, Colorado, before retiring. He married the love of his life, Lynn, in 1976, and inherited four children, Scotty Groth, Sherry Bender, Jerome Husband, Daryl Groth, Jackie Wife, Sean Groth, Jamie Wife. He is preceded in death by his father, Carl William Anderson, and mother, Marie Anderson. Those left behind to honor Carl's memory are his loving wife, Lynn, his four children, 13 grandchildren, and one great-grandchild, as well as numerous extended family and friends who are here to honor him today. Carl Roger Anderson, AKA Tiny. Roger to his family, or Carl to many of us, or I believe Sean said, itty bitty buddy, or he called you itty bitty buddy, you called each other itty bitty buddy. Either way, neither one of you is itty bitty. He was a man of many names, loyal and faithful to the Lord. Born April 9th, 1948 in Scottsbluff, Nebraska. He must have been one of these big Nebraska corn-fed boys. Should have been on the lineman. Went home to be with the Lord on May 29th, 2022. Carl was a devoted husband and father. He enjoyed being with his sweetie, and he said that to me many times. I miss my sweetie, Lynn, for 45 years. Raised four kids to be loving children and now adults. Siblings that pick on each other and often picked on their dad, and from what I'm told, continue to pick on each other. Some of the family were not listed on the obituaries. The paper with them listed was lost somewhere in the paper shuffle of the last 2 weeks. And I guarantee if any of you have been through this, you've lost a lot of things in the last 2 weeks and you can't find them, but that's okay. Audrey and Wayne Stevens, sister and brother-in-law from Newton, Kansas. Norma and Ken Miller from Cedar Ridge, Colorado. Dale Wilbur and Lisa Hirsch, brother-in-law and sister-in-law from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Larry Eigel and Cindy Eigel from Aberdeen, South Dakota. Son Scotty lives in Dupree, Iowa. Couldn't be with us due to his kidney dialysis. 3 times a week, by the way. Might want to put that in your prayers. Daughter Sherry and husband Jerome live in Aberdeen, South Dakota. Son Daryl and wife Jackie live in Dupree, Wisconsin. Son Sean and wife Jamie live in Buena Vista, Colorado. And I believe your daughter Claire, who, by the way, Claire, Carl wouldn't stop talking about you. To me, anyway. I'm sure it was everybody else. Kids have been helping their mom, like Carl asked them to do. Mowing, repairs, removing trip hazards, and the list goes on and on. Carl enjoyed fishing and boating, but was unable to do much of it in the last 6 years. He talked about it all the time with his friend, DJ, and anyone else who would listen. He enjoyed his Bible studies and visiting with the many attendees. He especially enjoyed his study in Revelation. He was a kid magnet. They sat on his lap, rode on his walker, and on his wheelchair. He played Santa 1 year at the children's Christmas party at church. As the kids were decorating cookies, he asked one young lady if he could have one of her frosted cookies. She told him, go and make your own. So much for that. I will add that when Carl was able to make a